Hey guys,
thought I would enjoy a sunset with you. How's everyone doing? Great to be back with you again tonight. Thank you for giving me the night last night to spend time with the family. I only made it about 20 minutes into Roadhouse, and hey, beautiful location, cool concept, but I think I'll go and watch the original. That's it. I don't want to be negative, so. Anyway, a lot to talk about tonight. First off, I want to shout out a thank you to the user XRP007. I appreciate the nod in your video. So thank you. It's important in communities like this where you have a lot of investors that don't have a lot of experience can get emotional. Experienced traders can get emotional too. No worries, but it might be more likely that somebody does a drastic thing out of emotion or lack of preparedness. So the more this community can support one another, whether you're in this floor of Club XRP or if you're out on the balcony terrorizing cats in New York City with the rest of us and Lou's Brigade, we're all part of the same giant club, so appreciate you, dude. So tonight, I'll break this up into videos like always. The first video is going to be straight to XRP, and I'm going to be talking about everybody's favorite things, price brackets. I also want to talk to you about a strategy that professionals use to maximize their gains in a way of laddering your sales during a climb up. We'll talk about all of it. We'll get into that. And I don't know. The word sell is so triggering to the AMC community. You have to understand we're not in the same world. This isn't a short squeeze. So it's no longer like anathema and sacrilegious to talk about selling. That's called taking gains. That's why you're in this game. If it's not, then it's a really shitty hobby. So we'll talk about price brackets, strategic selling, and I want to talk about the broader crypto market as a whole. I keep telling you guys, don't watch XRP. Watch XRP, Ethereum, and Bitcoin simultaneously. The ticker on my phone only shows me those three because I know what the rest of the crypto market generally, you always have your outliers, generally is going to do. It's like the taking the temperature of the market. It's simple, but it hasn't proven me wrong yet in the 7 or 8 years that I've been trading crypto. It works. Generally, it works. Most of the time, it works all the time. And that's what we're doing. We're riding with Bitcoin up and down. All right. Anyway, we're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about the launch of the crypto bull run. Holly's coming out the other side. So that's all tonight, okay? Separate videos. I got a bunch of people to introduce you to that are part of this family in a whole separate series I'm doing called The House That Lou Built. And that's where we're going to get to know who's in the family. And let me tell you something. Where are my notes? We got some really cool, interesting people among us. All right? People of all different types. You know, and I don't want to spoil anything. The House That Lou Built Episode 1 goes up tonight. Isn't it beautiful? That natural gradient. It will never cease to impress me. And on that note, you guys know that I've written a book. I'm writing a second book. I'm in a band. And now the YouTube thing, I was a professor. And at one point, thank you, dear. Could you gently lift your foot? That was the table that the phone is on. Oh, thank you, my love. Looks like an earthquake. It's all good. teacher. And once upon a time, I was a high school teacher. I taught high school English. That was before, that was during my undergrad. I did student teaching and substitute teaching. So I've always been a performer. I started playing the drums when I was, I'm going somewhere with this. When I was 5 years old, I started banging on pots and pans. I had seen a music video for a band called Kiss, and my five-year-old brain, so this was 1988, I was 5 years old, and I saw these guys painted up like crazy monsters, and I heard this sound, and I felt this beat, the opening to I Love It Loud, that It's like the most basic drum beat in the history of drum beats. It's like the one we teach you the second you sit down to a drum set for the very first time. Like, first time I heard that, something happened to me and I went, like, that. I want that. Whatever that is. Then, Guns N' Roses. The first time I saw Slash walk up on top of a Baldwin piano in this grand opera music hall and rip out one of two of the greatest solos ever written in rock and roll. Fight me, those are two of the best solos in rock and roll, was in November Rain. And he's standing on a piano ripping that solo, and then he's walking out of a deserted church into a desert, tumbleweeds going, his hat, the leather chaps, the cigarette in his mouth, and the one of the greatest solos ever written to this day. Come on. I became a musician in that moment. Been playing drums ever since. I'm 41 years old. I've been writing and creating music with my band since high school, ninth grade. Jose, my bassist, also a Puerto Rican male. I don't know what it is with me and Puerto Rican males. he and I, also a Lou fan. What up, Jose? He and I started writing music, and we were playing birthday parties for our friends. Horrible music. Fucking horrible. We had no business doing it. I think we were called School Bus Riot. We knew a Marilyn Manson song and a Green Day song, and we just kept playing them over and over and over. One time, this guy threw a beer bottle, hit one of us. I mean, we were in ninth grade, but hey, it's a rough scene out there. But that is the band that eventually evolved to now. We're 41, we got kids, we're married and shit. I got gray fucking hair. And I'm still writing music with these guys. Our album's almost finished, we sound better than we ever have. My point of all this rambling, and I'm gonna cut out this into its own little thing so that XRP people, you can go right to XRP, is I'm a performer. I'm an artist, I like to create, I need to create, it's a fucking need. And you have given me an audience, and I can't thank you enough, because it's something that I was kind of starving for a little bit. I'm a financial analyst. I work from home. I sit at computers all day. I stare at screens. I look at numbers. Yeah, it's so fucking smart, but it doesn't exactly scratch that creative itch. And, you know, it can be an unbearable feeling when you need to perform, when you need to connect to people through something. And you guys have given me that. So all the thank yous, thank you right back. All right, let's get into it. We got a lot to talk about tonight. I'll see you in the next one.